presenter is Dr. Santosh from AIIMS to present his case on obstructive jaundice.
Good morning. My patient, Mr. K, a gentleman aged 59 years, a resident of Silampur, Delhi.
Please make it into a slideshow.
Awesome. My patient, Mr. K, aged 59 years, a resident of Silampur, Delhi, is an agriculturist by occupation, belongs to lower middle socioeconomic status. He came to us with chief complaints of yellowish discoloration of the body with generalized itching and passage of high colored urine for 6 months, along with loss of appetite and weight loss for 2 months. The yellowish discoloration was first noted by family members over the face and eyes 6 months back, which was, and the patient simultaneously noted high passage of high colored urine. However, he did not notice any change in the color of stools. However, it was not absorbed. This yellowish discoloration was gradually progressive, and there was no waxing and waning of jaundice. It was associated with generalized itching and was more in the evening time. There were no prodromal symptoms. There was no pain. There was no decrease in the urine output. However, about 2 months back, he had an episode of fever which was associated with chills and rigors and lasted for about 5 days. It was relieved on injectable medications and was admitted in a private hospital. During this admission, he also underwent an endoscopy through mouth, following which his yellowish discoloration has reduced. He also has progressive loss of appetite for 2 months and associated with significant weight loss for 2 months. There's no history of vomiting, hematemesis, melena. There's no history of any altered bowel habits. No history of abdominal distension, and there's no history of any chest pain, hemoptysis, bone pain, and seizures. Patient does not have any significant comorbid illness. He has not undergone any previous abdominal surgeries or significant hospital admissions. There's no history of jaundice previously. There's no history of any blood transfusion. Patient hasn't taken any drug on a chronic basis. Personal history. Patient is predominantly a vegetarian by diet.
Hello.
He used to smoke BDs for the past 30 years, about one bundle of BD per day. He has consumed tobacco in the form of pan over past 25 years, about 3 to 4 times in a day. However, he denies any regular alcohol intake, high risk behavior. Sleep is normal, bowel habits and bladder habits are normal, and patient does not have any known allergies. Family history. There is no history of jaundice in the family or any cancer in the family related to breast, pancreas, colon or gonadal cancer. Both his parents expired of natural causes. To summarize the history, my patient, aged 59 years, has come with progressive painless jaundice associated with itching and high colored urine and significant loss of appetite and weight loss, and is a smoker and consumes tobacco.
History, now we stop. Generally, that's what we've been doing, Dr. Prabal. Anything?
You said it's a couple of points, very well presented. What is significant weight loss? Is that significant, what you just said? And what is his weight as such?
His weight was 50 kgs and now it has come down to 45.
So is that significant?
Yes, sir, this patient.
What is significant? Therefore, what is significant weight
significant
loss?
Significant weight loss is weight loss of more than 10% over 6 months or weight loss of 5% over 1 month.
Good.
Unintended
weight loss.
Unintended. You also talked about the sleep pattern. Why are you asking about the sleep pattern? What do you expect?
A reversal of sleep pattern is one of the first symptoms of liver cell failure, and that is important. increased daytime sleepiness is
right. Good. From the history, just from the history, what have you come to on a conclusion? Just from this, we haven't come to the examination. What is your conclusion? What are the things that you are trying to basically? Basically, you have to come to a diagnosis. You have to move a step ladder pattern. So, what are you? What have you?
From the history. Deciphered? From the history, I come to know that the patient is having jaundice. Now, I'd like to classify it if it's a medical jaundice or a surgical jaundice. So, based on the history, patient does not have any prodromal symptoms. So, and it's a painless progressive jaundice. So, I'd presume it to be an obstructive jaundice, and I'd like to proceed with clinical examination to confirm.
Well, what he's trying to ask you is, because often the examiner would ask you, based on history, where do you think you're going? It's a surgical jaundice or a medical jaundice?
This is a surgical jaundice.
Yes. What makes you think so in the history?
Patient has progressive jaundice and is not associated with prodromal symptoms, which
is... Yeah, so it's the other way around. There are no prodromal symptoms.